Hi, in this video, we'll be discussing a question on kinematics, which will consist of both the differentiation and integration topics. The question goes, the velocity v meters per second of a particle moving in a straight line t seconds after passing through a fixed point O is given by this expression, v equals to 27 divided by 2 multiplied by 3t plus 1 close bracket square minus away 3t plus 1 over 2. In part A of this question, find the initial acceleration of the particle, and that's a 2 marks question. In a part B of this question, determine with appropriate working whether the velocity of the particle is increasing or decreasing, and that's also another 2 marks question. In part C, you are to find the average speeds of this particle during the first 6 seconds, and that's a 6 marks question. You might want to pause this video to give this question a try, and when you're ready, keep watching. For the first part of this question, we are given the velocity equations, and we are to find the initial accelerations. So to find the initial accelerations, we need to find out what is the acceleration equations, and we can do so by doing a dv over dt. So acceleration A can be found by using a dv over dt. So differentiating v, which is this equation, with respect to t. Now, as you can see that there is a term that consists of bracket 3t plus 1 to the power of 2. This involves a chain rule differentiation. Let us recap on our chain rule differentiation here. So if y is equal to a multiplied by f of x to the power of n, your dy dx can be found by having a multiplied by power of n, that is to bring down power, and fx power of n minus 1. So bring down power of n and a power minus 1, multiplied by the differentiation result of what's within the bracket, which in this case refers to f prime of x. With these two formulas, we are ready to start to solve this question for part A. So for part A, we might want to first change the indices at the bottom over here to make it to the top. So using the negative indices rule over here, 3t plus 1 to the power of 2 can be shifted to the numerator, in this case to become a power of negative 2. The reason for doing so is to avoid careless mistake when doing our differentiation in the next few steps. So as mentioned, we need to write it out in order for us to find the accelerations. Acceleration can be found by using a dv over dt. So we can now proceed to differentiate this whole expression. So differentiating this will actually give us this. So bring down the power of negative 2, power minus 1. At the same time, you need to multiply by the differentiation result of what's within the brackets. So differentiate 3t plus 1 will actually give us a 3. Differentiate a negative 3 over 2t will actually give us a negative 3 over 2. And differentiating a negative half, in this case, will actually give us a 0. So simplifying this entire equation over here of A, using our calculator to simplify, we will be able to reduce until this. So what the question wants us to find is to find the initial accelerations. By initial acceleration, we are referring to t to be a 0. So when t to be a 0, we can change up the t to be a 0. We will be able to find your initial accelerations. So initial acceleration is actually, in this case, a negative 82.5 meters per second squared when t is equal to 0. And that's a very simple part A answer. In part B of this question, we are asked to find whether the velocity of this particle is increasing or decreasing. In order to find whether the velocity is an increasing function or decreasing function, we need to find the gradient of velocity. And the gradient of velocity is actually through your accelerations. So to determine whether a function is increasing over here, we can have this one. Increasing function will mean that the first order of the function is actually greater than 0. First order derivative of the function is actually greater than 0. So referring to a gradient over here, gradient of that function is more than 0. So decreasing function happens when the gradient is actually less than 0. For us to find the velocity, whether it's increasing or decreasing, we need to find a dv dt. And dv dt, which is your a, is actually found earlier. We just have to analyze this part to determine whether it's an increasing or decreasing functions. So over here, your A is actually dV over dt, and that it was actually this. As we can see here, t is always greater than or equals to zero because t refers to the time. Since t is greater than or equals to zero over here, 3t plus 1 to the power of 3 will definitely be a positive. And a negative 81 over 3t plus 1 to the power of 3 will definitely be a negative, minus away a 3 over 2, giving us a negative result. So this whole expression will be less than zero, causing the a to be less than zero, causing your dv over dt to be less than zero. That means to say your velocity is actually decreasing. So velocity of this particle is decreasing. And that's the answer for part B. Last part of this question, we have to find the average speeds of the particle during the first 6 seconds. So by average speed, we are referring to distance over time. And distance can be found by the displacement equations, and displacement in turn can be found by integrating a v with respect to t. So over here, integrating a v equation will mean integrating the right hand side, and as you can see here, there's a 3t plus 1 to the power of 2. So before we start integrating, we might want to revisit on the integration of power functions over here. So by integration of power functions, if we integrate ax plus b to the power of n dx, it will give us ax plus b to the power of n plus 1. So this n plus 1 means to say it's your power plus 1s divided by power plus 1s. At the same time, your denominator must multiply by an a. So the a came from the term within the brackets plus c, where c refers to the arbitrary constants from any integration results. So the conditions for this integration of power functions is that your n is not equals to a negative 1. And in this case, it is fine because your n is a negative 2 if you shift it upwards. And a is not equals to 0. Once again, your a is actually a 3. So this is perfectly fine. Your n cannot be a negative 1 because if n is a negative 1, we have to use another integration formula which involves a ln. So with your integration of power functions here, we can start to do our part C first step. So for part C, as mentioned earlier, displacement can be found by integrating a v dt. So when we are to integrate this part, before we integrate this part, let's not forget that in part A earlier, we have actually shifted the power of 2 to the top to become the power of negative 2. We will then be able to proceed to integrate this part. So 27 over 2 is just a constant, so you copy it down. Your 3t plus 1 has a power of negative 2. So power plus 1 to give us a minus 2 plus 1 divided by your power plus 1 minus 2 plus 1 in this case, as shown in the formula. At the same time, your denominator must multiply by a 3, which came from 3t within the brackets. Integrating a negative 3 over 2t is similar because a power of 1 plus 1, your power now becomes a 2, divided by the new power of 2 as well. And integrating a negative half will actually give us a negative half t. Plus a c, because c is an arbitrary constant from any integration results. So we might want to press a calculator to simplify this complicated numbers over here. You have 27 over 2 minus 2 plus 1 multiplied by 3 over here. So let's just press the calculator out to give us this answer. So as you can see here, how do we solve for this arbitrary constant? There should be an information given for us to solve this arbitrary constant. So over here, as you can see, this is the important part right here. So t seconds after passing through a fixed point O. So when a question says a fixed point O, it means displacement is equal to zero. So fixed point O means displacement is equal to zero. So when t equals to zero, displacement is equal to zero. So when t equals to zero, over here, when t equals to zero, you're going to replace all the t to be a zero like this. You set your displacement to be zero, you can solve for your c. So your arbitrary constant here can be solved like this. So t to be zero, s to be zero, c will therefore give us a 4.5 if you work it out with your calculator. And replacing your c to be a 4.5, your displacement equation can therefore be written in full like this. So this is now your displacement equation as seen here. So s equals to minus 9 over 2. At the bottom part, you have a 3t plus 1 close brackets minus away a 3 quarter t squared minus half t plus 4.5. So this is your displacement equations. Alright, before we start to solve for the distance from the displacement equation, it is worth noting that for most questions involving kinematics, there will be a reversal in direction, and this affects the distance greatly. So in order for us to find the reversal in directions, so that we can find the respective displacements and find the distance accordingly, you might want to first note that to find a reversal of direction, we are referring to an instantaneous rest. So instantaneous rest happens when a velocity to be equal to zero. This is to solve for t like this. So this is for us to find the reversal of directions for this particle. So by setting your v equation, which is in this case to be equal to zero on the right hand side, to find instantaneous rest. So setting your v to be equal to zero, you can solve for your t. So it's a very simple basic manipulation here. Your t will actually be just a 2/3. So let us now write out the when t is a zero, the displacement will actually be a zero, because t seconds after passing through a fixed point O. So this part here refers to t seconds after passing through a fixed point O. We can find out at the moment when it reverses its direction, it happens when it's an instantaneous rest, which is at t to be a 2/3. Replacing a t to be a 2/3 into the displacement equation like this, we can find the respective displacements. So replacing a t to be a 2/3, your s will actually be equal to 2 1/3. So this is actually, your displacement is actually to the right of the fixed point O, because a positive displacement means to the right. Okay, a positive displacement means to the right of the fixed point O. The next part, the timing will stop when we want to find the first 6 seconds. So over here, we want to find the first 6 seconds. First 6 seconds over here, that means to say we need to find t to be a 6. So for t to be a 6 over here, replacing the t to be a 6 in the same fashion, replacing the t to be a 6, replacing the t to be a 6, we can find for our displacement like this, which will give us a negative 25 and 14 over 19 in its exact form. So what does this mean? In other words, we need to draw a displacement diagram to better understand this part. So now let us draw the displacement diagram to better understand this part. So we have this displacement diagram. The particle starts moving here. When t is a 0, s is a 0. So this is the displacement axis. So when t is a 0, s is a 0 like this. All right. And at t to be a 2/3, the particle will reach a displacement of 2 1/3. That means to say it's traveling towards the right side. So at t to be a 2/3, your displacement is now a 2 1/3 over here. It's to the right of fixed point O. When t is a 6, which is few seconds later, your displacement is now a negative. That means to say it traveled all the way to the negative of displacement, which is to the left of your fixed point O. So this is its direction, it is traveling like this. So with this displacement diagram, we can start to find the distance. So by the distance over here, we're referring to this part. Total distance will therefore be equal to this. So let me elaborate on this part first. So the 2 1/3 multiplied by 2 in red box here on the right side refers to this portion of the distance. Okay, so this part will be 2 1/3. When it travels backwards, in this case to the left, it'll be another 2 1/3. So these two red lines refers to the 2 times 2 1/3 like this. At the same time, your 25 and 14 over 19 in this case will refer from 0 to here. So this is a negative because it's a displacement. If you want to take the distance, we need to take the absolute or modulus of this part, which in this case is 25 and 14 over 19. So this is now your total distance in this case, which is 30 and 23 over 57, dividing by the time of 6 seconds in this case, it shall give us the answer of this, 5.07 meters per second in 3SF. And that's the answer for this long questions.